your celebration. We have made a living on celebration, so we really aren't thrilled to be here. And it's seriously humbling to be given the honor of sharing the excitement of what lies ahead for you all as a graduating class of the University of Illinois 2015, class of 2015. Nothing inspires us and excites us more to be in a room surrounded by young and ambitious people ready to take on the world in a new way.
We are proud 2006 graduates of the College of ACES and the owners of LA Gourmet Catering and Paratree Estate. We opened LA Gourmet just 3 months after we graduated in September of 2006, and our incredible staff creates made from scratch high-end catering. We cater for 15 to 5,000. Over the last 9 years, we've catered literally thousands of special events, 900 weddings, cocktail parties, lunches, and more. Knowing that we're coming to share our story with you tonight allows us to reflect on the journey that got us here today. We asked each other scores of questions. We were immediately reminded of the interrogations that we faced upon graduation. Many of the questions you have probably faced and will suddenly hold tremendous weight tonight when you walk out of here with your diplomas. What are you going to do after you graduate?
How are you going to make money doing that? What are you going to do when that job doesn't work and you have to support yourself?
And how are you going to pull that out? All of those questions may seem overwhelming to some of you. The one thing that we can tell you tonight is that you are graduates of the University of Illinois. And if you take that and run with it, you can go as far as you want.
We are asked all these questions by our admissions, and believe me, our answers were not typical. And I'm pretty sure they were humorous to a lot of people. Thank you, Mom and Dad, for not laughing. This is what we said. We're going to start a business together out of one of our dad's farm shops. We sold our souls to get a loan from the bank last week. We also flew to Washington, D.C. because we bought a van on eBay. And we have $0, and we're going to move out of our amazing college apartment. We're going to move back into your house, Mom and Dad. We're going to share our childhood bedroom. Oh, by the way, on spring break, we got a dog. Her name's Ellie. She'll be living with us, too. So we started this business when we were in college. And other kids were writing like fake business plans, and we were writing real business plans. We had saved $2,000 up between the two of us, and we're looking in the Beaver for catering supplies. Well, we found a whole catering business that was going to be foreclosed. So we showed up there one Saturday morning, 7 a.m., and we offered them the entirety of our savings. They accepted our $2,000 offer with an eye roll and a handshake, and they said, "May God help you too." By the way, we left till the end of the day to get everything out of here. We called every family member we had, and we voted two semis of catering supplies that day, and we spent every Saturday for the next 2 years cleaning kitchen equipment and turning one of those shops on Dad's farm into a catering kitchen.
So what did we say when people asked us, how are you going to make money doing that after you graduate? Andy and I didn't start this business together just because we had a dream. We started this business together because we needed jobs. We've never simply been dreamers. We've always been doers. We were driven, we were creative, and we were poor. We were also, most importantly, very naive. No matter how prepared and educated we thought we were, we had no idea what we were getting ourselves into. We just kept moving forward. Once after that breaking event, our first full catering season, we were putting away 50 of those 6-foot round tables, and one of our servers was whining and declared, "This is why I'm going to college." And we asked the teacher and thought, "Joke's on you, we went to college." We're still left in our tails. We had that life. Thomas Edison said that opportunity is missed by most people because it's stressed and overall it looks like work. Don't miss opportunities because you're too blind to see work in front of you.
This may surprise you, but some people ask us, what are you going to do when that doesn't work and you can't afford to support yourself? Well, we're going to move back home to our parents, just like the rest of us. But really, we've been at rock bottom, working literally around the clock, sleeping for a couple minutes outside of our kitchen, taking 15-minute power naps, that's no joke, to get it through the night, and still scraping together money because neither one of us has shoes that weren't duct taped together. So some days we are overlooked, and honestly, I still feel like rock bottom. Because even with the full staff, there's not enough hours in the day always. And sometimes there's extraordinarily large events that you're never going to be staffed enough for. But that's what you do. Sometimes because an angel opens the door, sometimes because you're a great family, conversation you overheard us having with the student when the student asked us, well, what are you going to do if this doesn't work? What if that fails? We didn't have a backup plan. Failure was never an option. We were going to make this work. If at some time in your future you don't know what rock bottom feels like, you're living too cautiously. We knew what we needed to do to create a successful business, but it took us 5 years of real struggles, hard work, persistence, exhaustion, a lot of things to bring that business plan to life. The ability to stop by the people and down upon it and making no money led us to the best decision, but it truly was one of the hardest decisions that we ever made. During that time, though, the greatest lesson we could have learned about was human kindness. And we learned more from that than we ever could have learned if our lives were perfect. So that was chapter one. That was chapter one. Here's chapter two. 6 years ago, Morgan got married, and she had a little baby boy named Jack. And you both fell madly in love with that little man. And we knew at that point that we could not keep at running at the pace that we were running with little to show for it. So sometime shortly after the wedding, her husband, who's amazing, asked, so what do you think you're going to get paid, Danny? That was like the hardest question. It was always our first priority to reinvest into our company and grow our company. But we had to be investing in ourselves and our people. So 4 years ago, we had a realization that we had an amazing staff. They had helped us so much. A majority of them amazing graduates as well, actually. So it was time to take a giant step forward. We wanted to create opportunities for them to grow their careers and be a part of something bigger. Something had to change. Yes, we were booked a year out, our phone was running off the hook, we couldn't handle any more work, but we hadn't reached that tipping point of profitability.
So we reevaluated what we created as a high-end catering company and assessed that many of the orders that we were taking were increasing our gross sales, but they weren't helping our margins. For instance, we were doing hundreds of off lunches, literally 30,000 a year. And we were like little business cards we were dropping out of the town, but we weren't making money on them. And it wasn't fair to our staff or our company. So we realized that most of our money and the things that we needed to focus our staff and our resources on were our special events. But we also knew that event catering was limited because there are very few venues in town, and the University of Illinois was our largest client, still is, but they would be greatly affected by the state of Illinois budget. So it was time to take another huge risk. But instead of the $60,000 we needed to start out of our bank, we needed $2 million just to get started. So we leveraged everything, and our financial backing came from our longtime bank relationship and some programs through the county, and we got that money because they all believed in us because we have always been doers. We built an open pantry estate, an 11,000 square foot venue on a farm in the heart of Illinois Prairie. The decision to open Paratory State wasn't as easy as just getting a loan, like that was a simple cakewalk. Andy was searching for the perfect spot for 2 years, and when she saw this space, she had a vision for us that most of us just shook our heads. But it was perfect. Our first pitch, though, was in a zone to Ag 1, which we didn't have a problem with, we're farmers' daughters, but we wanted to be able to embrace that space. And so we started with the zoning process, and while we'll spare you the gory details, it was a year of learning about people and them coming together and supporting us, we fought to make this plan a reality. Once again, it was the best decision and the best lesson in civics we could have experienced. Once we finally received the green light from zoning, due to the contract delays and weather, we literally had 86 days to build this 11,000 square foot facility. And we did it before our first booked event. It was the longest, quickest, hardest, busiest 86 days of our lives. Paratree has brought the best food, service, and experience to Central Illinois. And every day is full of thousands of questions. And growing isn't easy, but it is ours. A saying that we keep on our desk says that if your dreams don't scare you, your dreams aren't big enough. Live big enough that failure is an option, but work hard enough that you overcome the odds. This is where the doing not dreaming comes into play. Nothing about this was a dream, but we had no money. And we just kept doing what we know how to do. We showed up and worked. The lessons have not been few and far between. There is a huge learning curve still in front of us, but it is becoming a little less steep. And now this new venue has given us room to grow, at least for a little more time.
How are you going to pull that off? You're going to appreciate the people in your corner. That's how you're going to pull life off. You're going to love them, and listen to them, and learn from them. For us, it was the business people in our community. It was reading every book that we could have got our hands on. It was getting the best jobs and the best internships to gain the most experience that we could. It was the people right here in this room from this college. And most importantly, it was our family. Especially our parents. Never underestimate. Find a person that when you breathe in the face of fear, rise in the face of fear.
A person that challenges you when you feel comfortable. A person that knows how to make you tip and do anything that will never make you stop. For that, that was also each other.
Grab the good people around you and don't let them go. If you aspire to be the next top food scientist or race lake, rise stop engineer, the next vice for John Deere, they all have steps to make that happen. Talk to the experts, but most importantly, listen to what they have to say. We don't advertise. We show up, we connect with people, and we make memories. There was a time when we were paving so much of ACES library, we asked each other if we could just set up shop in the heritage room. Every time we catered there, it felt like we were coming home. We love getting to know everyone on a new level and learning from conversations. During our starting years, we formed an amazing relationship while soaking up the knowledge from everyone around us. When it came time to build our building, it was truly astonishing how many people came together to pull off the impossible in 6 days. There's this amazing hand-carved sign when you walk in the fair tree that states, surround yourself with the dreamers and the doers, the leaders and thinkers. But most of all, surround yourself with those who see greatness within you, even when you don't see it within yourself. To say that this we saw this goal come to life in the late 6 days, it would be an understatement. One of those moments was when one of our ACES teachers, Jill Kraft, called, with about 35 days left to help me open, and she said, hey, what can we do? Her and her husband showed up, many conversations, tears, and deep breaths later, with hand-carved lettering for our interest sign at Fair Tree Estate. Commissioner Mitch and I also made that amazing sign in the lobby when we went for Fair Tree. Never underestimate the power of helping another human when you have people who truly care and reform. Make connections, not to be the person that's well connected, but because those connections will grow and flourish and possibly change your life. Your connections will become mentors and friends, and they will provide inspiration and knowledge.
So 9 years later, we've gone from a company where our gross sales were $50,000 to over $2 million in gross sales. We've gone from a staff of two,
perfect staff,
to a staff of 14 full-time and 60 part-time employees. As for LA, in case you're wondering, our dog still lives with our parents, but we're hopeful that one day she'll get a job with the
community. Let your experience be your best asset. An experience allows you to think in unconventional ways. So ditch that dream and be a doer. You don't have to know what your passion might be today. I don't even think it matters. You don't have to know what you want to do today. You just have to keep doing something. Seizing the next opportunity. Being open to new ideas. Be open to try something new. It doesn't have to be your perfect job or vision of your perfect life. Perfect is boring. The world has enough dreamers. While the rest of the world is busy dreaming, be a third person that's interesting, engaged, and brave. Be a doer.
So let's get this party started. That's something we definitely know a